Hi everyone. We're still at the topic 3, differentiation of exponential log and trig functions. Here I have 15 questions for the reinforcement practice. For the question 1, find dy dx for y equals to 3 power of 2x plus 1. To differentiate this exponential function, I'm going to use the formula because to differentiate the exponential function, for example, if I have a power of fx, to get your dy dx, I'm going to differentiate the powers and then copy itself, copy the function, and then multiply by log a. This is the formula to differentiate the exponential function, which the base is other than e. So now I have a 3 power of 2x plus 1. Using this formula, I differentiate the power first, I got 2. Differentiate 2x plus 1, you got 2. And copy the function itself. You have a 3 power of 2x plus 1 and multiply by log a. A is your 3, so you have a log 3. Simplify it, you will have a 2 log 3 multiplied by 3 power of 2x plus 1. Question 2, y equals to 4x plus 1 multiplied by e power of x. Question asks us to get a dy dx and then the second derivative. So here you can see that here is the linear function. I will take it as my u, and this is the exponential, take it as v. Then later on, we're going to apply the product rule. If your u equals to 4x plus 1, u prime will be equals to 4. If b equals to ex, then b prime will be ex. Then I will get my dy dx by applying the product rule, u v prime multiply plus v u prime, which my u is a 4x plus 1, and v prime ex plus v is your ex, and the u prime is 4. So look at these two terms. I have my ex at both terms. Factor out the ex. Okay, then you will see that you have a 4x plus 1 for the first term. And the second term, you have 4. This can be simplified further, which you will get ex multiplied by 4x plus 5. This is the dy dx. And after that, you're going to get your second derivative. I will take this as my u and this as a v. Alright. So u equals to ex. U prime. U prime will be ex. And the v is a 4x plus 5. V prime will be 4. So to get my d2y dx too, apply the product rules. U multiplied by v prime, that will be 4e to the power of x plus v u prime, which is taking the 4x plus 5, multiplied by ex. Then I have ex for both them, factor out the ex. I got 4 plus 4x plus 5. Finally, we have a 4x ex multiplied by 4x plus 9. This is our d2y dx2. For this question, again, we'll stick to the formula y equals to a power of fx. If you want to differentiate this type of function, get your dy dx by using this formula. Alright, copy down the function itself and differentiate the function and multiply by log a. Okay, so here I have my fx equals to 2 power of log x plus 1, as if that this is your power of fx. So you need to differentiate this, copy the function itself, and then differentiate the power, and then multiply by log 2. So here I got my f prime x. Copy the function back. I have my 2 power of log x plus 1. Multiply by. You need to differentiate the power, which is differentiate the log. Differentiate log, you have your 1 over x plus 1. Because differentiate log, you need to differentiate the function. Put it as a numerator. And divided by is the function itself. That is your x plus 1. You got it 1 over x plus 1. And multiply by log a, which is your log 2. So we rearrange our answer. We will have a 1 over x plus 1. On top, you have a log 2. Multiply by 2 power of log x plus 1. Question 4a, we are going to find the first derivative and the second derivative. Given the y equals to xe, this is your solution for the a. Xe power of negative 5x. Get your y prime. Y prime means your first derivative. I'm going to apply the product rule for this. This is as a u and this as a v. So just write down your u equals to x, u prime equals to 1. V equals to e power of negative 5x. Then your v prime will be a negative 5 e power of negative 5x. After that, I substitute into my y prime, which is I apply the product rules. So substitute the u as your x. And your v prime is a negative 5 e power of negative 5x plus v is your e to the power of negative 5x multiplied by u prime, which is 1. So I have e power of negative 5x. I take out, I factor it out. I have my negative 5x plus 1. Okay, so this is your y prime. To get the y double prime is referred to the second derivative. Again, I'll let this become the u, this become the v, just write down. U is your e power of negative 5x, and u prime is negative 5 e power of negative 5x. Then v equals to negative 5x plus 1 means that the v prime will be negative 5. Substitute into the product rule again. Okay, we're going to take the u multiplied by v prime, which is negative 5 multiplied by e power of negative 5x plus v multiplied by u prime, which is negative 5x plus 1 multiplied by negative 5 e power of negative 5x. Then we observe the solution. We can see that both them containing the e power of negative 5x. Take it out. And you have negative 5 inside the bracket for the first term. Second term, you have your negative 5x plus 1 multiplied by negative 5. Alright, then we can further simplify. This is your negative 5. Negative 5 multiplied by negative 5, you got 25x. And here you have a negative. Negative 5 multiplied by 1, you get negative 5. Then simplify again, you have your 25x minus 10. And we can see that 25 and 10, there is a common factor between them. So we can take it out. The common factor is 5. Take out the 5. Factor out the 5. You have a 5x minus 2 inside the bracket. This is your y double prime. For question 5, y equals to 4 power of 2x minus 1. Again, we stick to the formula. If we have a power of fx, dy dx will be equivalent to, copy back the function itself and differentiate the power and multiply by the log a. So this is as if that this is your a, the 4 is your a, and the fx is your 2x minus 1. To get the dy dx, I'm going to use this formula. Copy back the function itself, that is the 4 power of 2x minus 1. Multiply by differentiate the power, you have 2, and multiply by log 4. Rearrange your answer, that will be 2 log 4 multiplied by 4 power of 2x minus 1. Now we go back to the question 4. Just now I have overlooked question 4. Actually, there's a part B. So we come back to the question 4B. Differentiate the y equals to a log 3x minus 2x over 5x minus 1 with respect to x. So now we look at the solution for this. Differentiate this. To differentiate this function, I'm not going to start with the differentiation. I will rewrite my question into this form using the laws of log. I will have this. Then I will start to differentiate. Differentiate log 3 minus 2x, I have negative 2 over 3 minus 2x. Use the formula, which is differentiate this function, the inner function, 3 minus 2x, you get negative 2, and over the function itself, 3 minus 2x. Minus, differentiate log 5x minus 1, you need to differentiate the 5x minus 1 first, put it as a numerator, then over the 5x minus 1. Okay, so if you like to equate denominator, it's up to you, but I'll just leave my answer. Now we proceed to the question 6. We have a function e power of 2x multiplied by log. So take this as a u and this as your v. U equals to e power of 2x, then u prime will be 2 e power of 2x. If your v equals to a log 3x plus 4, then your v prime will be 3 over 3x plus 4. How do we get that? That is, differentiate the 3x plus 4. We got 3, put it as a numerator over the 3x plus 4. This is the formula to differentiate the log function. Then I need to get my fx, f prime x. F prime x, we're going to apply the product rule, which we're going to take the u multiplied by v prime, which is you have e power of 2x multiplied by 3 over 3x plus 4. And then taking the v multiplied by u prime, that will be the log 3x plus 4 multiplied by 2 e power of 2x. Then we'll see the, alright, this both of the term containing the e power of 2x, we can just factor it out. We have a 3 over 3x plus 4 plus log 3x plus 4. Okay, sorry, here another 2 here. Alright, 2 log 3x plus 4. After that, the question not asking just only the f prime x, it asks for the f prime 0, meaning that you need to substitute the 0 into your f prime x. So I'm going to get my f prime 0, means that I'm going to substitute the 0 into my answer. E power of 2 multiplied by 0, and then I have a 3 over 3 multiplied by 0 plus 4, plus 2 log 3 multiplied by 0 plus 4. Alright, so e power of 2 multiplied by 0, 2 multiplied by 0 will be 0. So 2 power e power of 0 will be 1. 3 over, this is 0, 3 over 4, I got 3 over 4. Outside 1 is okay, it just don't write the 1, it will be the mean the same result. Okay, 3 over 4 plus 2 log 4. 2 multiplied by log 4 because this producing 0, so 0 plus 4, you get 4. Or you want to simplify to the simplest form, that will be 3 over 4. And you can change the 4 over here to be 2 power of 2. And later on, use a loss of log, bring the 2 over to the front. Join with the 2, multiply by 2, you got 4, 4 log 2. Or you may leave your answer into decimal, that will be 3.523. Okay, 3.523, yes. Okay, or you can leave in this form, it's good enough for you. Alright, then we move to next question. So for this question, so question 7, we are going to differentiate this function and the answer already given. Okay, so we need to show. Right, to get a for okay, so the formula to differentiate a log gx, okay, if I have a function y equals to log gx, to get your dy dx, I'm going to take a differentiate the gx, you get g prime x divided by gx, this is the formula. So now we'll stick to the same formula to get your dy dx, take this as your gx. Now I'm going to differentiate this function, okay, to get your g prime x. So differentiate this function, you got 2 negative sine 2x. Alright, the 2 differentiate, you can see this as a 2 layers function. Differentiate cos, you get negative sign. And then differentiate the 2x, you get 2. Divided by gx. Okay, according to the formula, you need to divide by gx. Gx is your cos 2x. Then sine over cos, you have a tangent. Negative 2, just copy it down. Sine 2x over cos 2x, you can convert into the tangent 2x. So you have you can say that you have shown the statement. Proceed to the question 8. This function, we take it as a u and this as a v. Again, we apply the product rules. Write down your u as your e2x. So your u prime will be 2e2x. And v equals to tangent x. V prime will be secant square x. Alright. Then to get your dy dx, we're going to apply the product rules. Which are, I'm taking the u multiplied by v prime. You get your e2x multiplied by secant square x plus v multiplied by u prime, tangent x multiplied by 2e2x. So for these two terms, we can see that both terms containing the e2x, take out the e power of 2x, you have your secant square x plus 2 tangent x. Alright. For the question 9, I will rewrite my function y in this form, which is tangent 4x, and the whole thing multiplied by, to the power of 3. And I'll see this function as a 3-layer function, which the first layer is power of 3, and the second layer is tangent, third layer will be 4x. I'm going to differentiate layer by layer. Let's see what happens. Dy dx is equal to differentiate the first layer, meaning that differentiate something, power of 3. You will take the 3 over to the front, and provide a bracket to write down the inner function. The power minus 1, you get power of 2. Whatever inside this bracket, you just copy it down. That will be tangent 4x. Multiply by differentiate the second layer. Second layer is a tangent. We don't mind, we don't care what is inside this bracket. We just need to know differentiate tangent, we get secant square. Then the inner function, we just copy down. Multiply by differentiate the inner function, which is my third layer. Differentiate 4x with respect to x, you have 4. And you have complete everything, you simplify. 3 multiplied by 4, 12. 12 multiplied by tangent square 4x. And multiply by secant square 4x. That's it. For the question 10, we need to obtain the second derivative for the this function cos 3x over e power of 2x and express your answer into the simplest form. So we need to get to differentiate this function, find the first derivative first, then only we proceed to the second derivative. To get the first derivative, I will apply the quotient rule, let u become the cos 3x, get your u prime, and the v is e power of 2x, v prime is a 2 e power of 2x. Then we're going to substitute all this into the formula quotient rule. Dy dx, the formula for the quotient rule is v u prime minus u v prime over v square. So v is your e power of 2x multiplied by u prime is your negative 3 sine 3x. Minus u v prime, which v is a cos 3x and u v prime is 2 e power of 2x. Then we're going to divide all this by v square, which will produce e power of 4x. And after that, we look at this numerator, both them containing e power of 2x. We can factor out the e power of 2x. Alright, then the 2 over here, need to write it down, over e power of 4x. Here, you can see that this can be cancelled off. This becomes e power of 2x. Finally, we have a negative 3 sine 3x minus 2 cos 3x over e power of 2x. This is your dy dx. To get the d2y dx, too, now I'm going to apply the, again, I apply the quotient rule, which take this as a u and a down function, lower function as a v. So if a u equals to a negative 3 sine 3x minus 2 cos 3x, what is a u prime? U prime is a negative 3, just write it down, negative 3. And this will be 3 cos 3x. Differentiate sine 3x, you get 3 cos 3x minus negative 2, okay, minus 2. And then differentiate cos 3x, you get a negative 3 sine 3x. Simplified it, you have a negative 9 cos 3x plus 6 sine 3x. Then the v equals to e power of 2x, v prime will be 2 e power of 2x. Then you can proceed to your d2y dx too. Apply the quotient rule again. Quotient rule, v multiplied by u prime means that you have the e power of 2x multiplied by u prime, which is negative 9 cos 3x plus 6 sine 3x. And minus u v prime, which is v, u is your negative 3 sine 3x minus 2 cos 3x. And this is going to be multiplied by 2 e 2x. And all this will be divided by v squared, which is your e power of 4. And look at the both term. This both term containing e power of 2x. To simplify, I will just factor out the e power of 2x. Then just write down what you left for the first term. You have a negative 9 cos 3x plus a 6 sine 3x. And now we're going to multiply. You get a negative 3 multiplied by 2. You get a negative 6. Negative 6 multiplied by negative, you get positive 6 sine 3x. And this negative 2 multiplied by 2, you get negative 4. Negative 4 multiplied by negative, you get a positive cos. Positive 4 cos 3x. And this is divided by e power of 4x. Again, the e power of 2x and e power of 4x, it can be cancelled off. We left the denominator as the e power of 2x. Then what we have is, we are going to simplify the term, the like term. You have a 6 negative 9 cos 3x plus 4 cos 3, cos 3x. Then simplify, you get a negative 5 cos 3x. And 6 plus 6, you get 12, right? Like them. 6 sine 3x plus 6 sine 3x, you get 12 sine 3x. And down here, still have e power of 2x. Alright, this is the answer. To solve the question 11a, I have a function y equals to sine log 3x. So we'll see this as a three-layer function. The first layer is sine, second layer is log, and the third layer is 3x. So I will differentiate layer by layer to get the dy dx. I differentiate the sine first. Just ignore whatever inside here. We just later on just need to copy down. Differentiate sine, you get cos. And we have a bracket to copy down the inner function. Multiply by, differentiate the second layer. Second layer, differentiate log x, you get 1 over x, right? So differentiate log, you get a 1 over 3x. So this is the inner function that you copy down. Okay? And multiply by, differentiate the third layer function, you get 3. So you have you can see that the 3 over here can be cancelled off. Then you simplify it, you will have 1 over, sorry, it's a cos log 3x over x. Then for the question 11b, we have this function. 11b, I have this function, we're going to differentiate it term by term. For this first term, we're going to apply the quotient rule. We are going to apply the quotient rule. And for the second term, we're going to apply the product rule. So just to, we try to apply the quotient rule for the first term. We let this become the u, this become the v. So our quotient rule is copy down the v first. Multiply by u prime, which is differentiate the upper function, that is 1, minus copy down the u, which is your x, and differentiate the v, which is 3x squared. And this is over v squared. Alright, this is your v squared. Plus, okay. Now, I'm going to deal with the second term. Second term consists of e power of 2x multiplied by tangent x. I'll take this e power of 2x as a u and the tangent as a v. Now we apply the product rule, okay, for the second term. I'm using the red pen to represent the second term. So, what is the product rule? We copy down one of the functions that you like, e power of 2x. Then, differentiate the v, get your v prime. Differentiate, you get secant square x plus Alright, copy down the v, which is your tangent x, and differentiate this e power of 2x, you get a 2e power of 2x. Okay, then we simplify it. Simplify this first term, which I have wrote it in the green pen. Just simplify, you get the x power of 3 plus 1 minus 3x cubed over x cubed plus 1 square. And for the second term, you have e power of 2x. Just copy down first, just trying to simplify and see what we can do later on. Second term, you have, for this term, you have 2e power of 2x tangent x. Okay. Then we can see that x cubed minus 3x cubed can be simplified into negative 2x cubed. This is over x cubed plus 1 square. And the e power of 2x, you can just factor out if you want. Then we have a secant square x plus 2 tangent x. Alright, this is the question 12 for the reinforcement. So this is a parametric equation. Yeah, you can see that the x and y in terms of t. X is in terms of t, that is a cos 2t, and y is a 2t plus sine squared t. To differentiate to get the dy dx of this question, the parametric equation, we can apply the chain rule by finding the dy dx using the chain rule is a dy dt multiplied by 1 over dx dt. Okay, so dy dt multiplied by 1 over dx dt will produce a dy dx. So from this formula, we can see that we need the dy dt and dx dt in order to get the dy dx. First, we get our dx dt first. Differentiate x with respect to t, differentiate cos 2t with respect to t, you have a negative 2 sine 2t. And dy dt means that you differentiate this 2t plus sine square t with respect to t, you get 2 plus, how do you differentiate sine square t? You're having the 2 sine t and then multiply by cos t. You see this as a two layers function. The first layer is power of 2. How do you differentiate the power of 2? You're taking the 2 to the front and write down the inner function, that is sine. And the power of sine, you will minus 1. Alright? You will minus 1 and you get 1. After that, you differentiate the inner function, which is a differentiate sine, you get cos t. Alright? So this is your dx dt and dy dt. So to get the dy dx, we're using this formula that is applying the chain rule. You have your dy dt, that is a 2 plus 2 sine t. Sorry, sine t, cos t, and divided by the x dt, that will be negative 2 sine 2 t. Okay, this is multiplied by 1 over the x dt, means that divided by the x dt. Okay, then when we factor out the 2, we will have 1 plus sine t cos t, divided by negative 2 sine 2 t. Then you can see that this can be cancelled off, the 2. And we have 1 plus sine t cos t divided by negative 2, negative sine 2 t. Or you may split them into two terms. That will be negative 1 over sine 2 t plus sine t cos t divided by negative sine 2 t. Yes. Okay. What they want us to prove is this one, this statement. Okay, so you can have your negative, this is 1 over sine 2t, you can have a cosecant 2t, negative cosecant 2t, and here you want to prove it, you want to prove your statement until this term become negative 1 over 2, you're going to apply the laws of log. This one you can have 2 and divided by 2, okay, 2 divided by 2, then you have your positive multiplied by negative, you get negative, 2 sine t cos t can be converted into sine 2t. Divided by 2 sine 2t. Alright? Then this can be cancelled out. Here become 1. Okay, finally you will have negative cosecant 2t minus 1 over 2. So you have proven the statement that they asked for. That is negative cosecant 2t minus 1 over 2. And for the question 13, it's also about the parametric equation. You have x and y in terms of theta. But we're not going to discuss a B question because this is not in your syllabus. We just will find a dy dx by using the chain rule. So here, I have my x equals to cos theta. You can write into this form, cos theta cubed. And the y is a sine theta cubed. And you see this as a two layers function. First layer function is power of 3. Second layer function is cos. Alright? Then to differentiate, to get your dy dx, I'm going to get my dx dt first. Get your dx dt by differentiating in the form like two layers function. You differentiate the layer by layer. First layer, you differentiate the power of 3, you get this. And the inner function, you just copy down in the bracket. After that, multiply by, differentiate the inner function, you get negative sign. Negative sign theta, simplify, you will have a negative sign cos square theta sine theta. This is your dx dt. To get your dy dt, the same things will apply. I will see this as my first layer function, the power of 3. Power of 3 as a first layer function. Second layer, I will take it as, the sine theta will be my second layer function. To get your dy d theta, sorry, not t, it's a theta. Okay, differentiate with respect to theta, because this is in terms of theta. Then I want to find dy d theta first before I proceed to dy dx. Okay, so get your dy d theta by differentiating the first layer function, writing down the 3, and the power minus 1, you get 2. Inner function, just copy down. And multiply by, differentiate the second layer function, you get the cos theta. Then, you have a 3 sine square theta multiply by cos theta. This is your dx theta and dy theta. So now we proceed to the dy dx. To get your dy dx again, we'll apply the chain rule dy d theta divided by dx d theta. Okay, dy d theta over dx d theta. So now I have a negative 3 for the, dy d theta on top. So you have a 3 sine square theta cos theta, that is a dy d theta, you put it on top, divided by dx d theta, this is a negative 3 cos square theta sine theta. Then you observe which number can be cancelled off. You have your sine cancel off and the cos cancel off. Then lastly, you have your answer as a negative sine over cos, that is your tangent theta. Okay, so A, find dy dx, express your answer in terms of theta. Yes, this is the answer, negative theta. Question 14, again, we are dealing with this parametric equation. Okay, so again, this question B, I'm not going to discuss because it's not in the syllabus. I just will show you how to find the dy dx. So to get your dy dx, just copy down your question first. You have your x equals to negative 9 sine power of 3 t, and y equals to 3 minus 3 cos power of 3t. To get your dy dx, firstly, we need to find our dx dt and the dy dt. Dx dt, negative 9, is a coefficient, just copy down. And the sine power of 3t, to differentiate it, differentiate the outside outer function, which is differentiate the power of 3. Bring over the 3 to the front, and copy down the inner function. Power of 3 minus 1, you got 2. Multiply by, differentiate the inner function, which is your sine, sine t, you get your cos t. And then simplify, you will have negative 27 sine square t multiplied by cos t. Okay, this is your dx dt. To get your dy dt, again, differentiate 3, you get 0. And negative 3 is your coefficient, just copy it down. And I will see the cos power of 3 t as a two-layer function. The first layer is power of 3. Differentiate power of 3, I got the 3 to the front. Inner function, copy down. And the power of 3 minus 1, you got 2. And now you differentiate the inner function, which is your cos, you get negative sign. Okay, then you simplify. Negative multiply by negative, you get positive. Positive 9. Cos square t multiplied by sine t. This is your dy dt. And now we're going to prove that the dy dx is negative 1 over 3 cotangent t. So get your dy dx. Again, the dy dx is equals to the dy dt divided by dx dt. Alright, so dy dt equals to 9 cos square t sine t. Divided by dx dt, that will be negative 27 sine square t cos t. So now I'm going to cancel off whatever I can cancel. That is one of the sine cancel, this is a left sine t. And the cos also the same. And the 9 also the same. We have a negative 3 down there. Then write down your answer. That will be negative cos over sine, that will be cotangent. Okay, and you get the coefficient negative 1 over 3 cotangent t. Alright, cos over sine equivalent to cotangent t. That's it. Alright, let's check back the question. Yes, now they want us to prove that the dy dx is negative 1 over 3 cotangent t, and we have done it. Alright, for the last question, question 15. Okay, this is the last question on our reinforcement practice. We have a quotient function which is in the form of sine x over 1 plus cos x. I'm going to take this as my u function, this my v function, and apply the quotient rule. So if the u equals to sine x, what is your u prime? That will be cos x. V equals to 1 plus cos x, then your v prime will be negative sine x. Because I differentiate 1, you get 0. Differentiate cos, you get negative sine. After that, we are going to apply the quotient rule to get the dy dx. That will be v u prime minus u v prime over v squared. So put in your v, plug in your v, that will be 1 plus cos x. Multiply by u prime, that is cos x, minus u sine x. And the v prime is negative sine x. Then all this divided by 1 plus cos x squared, which is your v squared. Now I'm going to expand it, see anything can be simplified. I got my cos x plus cos square x plus sine square x. Yes, something can be simplified. You can see that this cos x plus sine x plus sine square, cos x plus cos square plus sine square, you get 1. So now you can simplify your answer into 1 plus cos x over 1 plus cos x square. Then still can be simplified. That is, cancel out the 1 plus cos square, on top you left 1. Finally, you have a 1 over 1 plus cos x only. Alright, then the question asking for the d2y dx2 as well. So we are going to get the d2y dx2 by differentiating this function once again. To get your d2y dx2, maybe I would like to write this into the form of 1 plus cos x power of negative 1. Alright, this is the x, not alpha, x. Eh? Okay. So d2y dx2, we are going to see this as a two layers function. First layer function is a power of negative 1. Second layer function is a 1 plus cos x. Alright, so now I'm going to differentiate the first layer, bringing the negative 1 to the front. Alright, and then the power minus 1, you get negative 2. Inner function, just copy down, you have a 1 plus cos x. Multiply by, differentiate the inner function, differentiate 1, you get 0. Differentiate cos, you get negative sine. And then you simplify your answer, you got a sine x. Negative multiply by negative, you got positive. Sine x over 1 plus cos x squared. Alright, this is your d2y dx. Okay, so done our explanation, my explanation on the reinforcement practice on topic 3. Yeah? So I'll see you on the next chapter, that is the topic 4, application of differentiation. Thank you.